Hello friends, today we will learn about simplex, complex, multiplex element and their interpolation functions, how they are going to vary according to these different elements. So let's get started. So if you see any FEA modeling, you have to do a mesh model. So in that mesh, you will create a number of elements and number of nodes. So according to the model, it may be a 1D, 2D or 3D mesh. So according to this mesh, it will use 1D, 2D or 3D elements. Okay. So next thing is these elements uses some interpolation functions. So according to that interpolation function, its results are going to vary. So on the basis of this interpolation function and these elements combinedly together form a three types of elements, three categories we will get. So these categories are simplex, complex and multiplex. Okay, so we will start with that. Okay, so here we are having a category simplex, complex and multiplex. These are the element shapes. Now if we go for 1D element, so we use this link element. So these link elements are having simple link elements having corner nodes. And if you go further, so this link element having intermediate nodes. So these intermediate nodes, so these are called as a simplex elements, which uses a corner nodes as well as the interpolation function for this simplex element are linear. And while in this complex element, if we are getting these intermediate nodes, internal nodes, so first of all, this one uses a quadratic equation interpolation function. And it is using a cubic shape interpolation function. So these are the complex elements. Now if we go for 2D, we are using a triangular elements. So again, it is having a corner nodes and it is going to use a linear shape function. That's why it is called as again a simplex element. So next, in this triangular element, we are having these intermediate nodes. And because of that, it is going to use a quadratic and cubic interpolation shape function. So interpolation functions are greater than linear, that is cubic or quadratic. So we are called it as a complex shape function. Further, if we go for 3D, so tetrahedron elements are used. So it is having four nodes at the four corners. And it is a linear tetrahedron. So it is comes under this simplex category. And this comes under a complex category. Now if we go for multiplex element, so quadratic element and hexahedral elements are considered to be a multiplex element. They are always considered as a multiplex element. What is the property of this element? So these quadratic elements are always to be parallel to x and y axis. So if you see here, they are parallel to x and y axis. So what is the edge over here? It should be parallel to this axis. It should be parallel to this axis. So this will give you a multiplex element. So what is the basic difference between these elements? We will see. Okay, so we will simply start with the first 1D elements. So this is simple 1D link element. It is having two nodes at its corner. And what is the interpolation function? That is T. T is the interpolation function. A1 plus A2X. So it is having degree 1. So that is, it is called as a linear interpolation function. So this comes under a simplex element. Now if we go adding one more node in this link element at the intermediate point, so it will increase the number of nodes to 3. and we are getting this quadratic shape function, that is x square. So interpolation function becomes t is equal to a1 plus a2x plus a3x square. So this is the one term is going to add here. So that's why it is called as a complex element. Again, if we add one more node, so number of nodes become 4. So two intermediate nodes are added in this link element. And we will get one more term over here, a4x cube. So this equation becomes a cubic equation. So this is called as a complex element. Okay. So next is for 2D element. So 2D, we are using this triangular element. So it is having all corner nodes and number of nodes equal to 3. And equation over here is interpolation function t is equal to a1 plus a2x plus a3y. So here we are getting y term because it is a 2D, and if you see the degrees over here, it is a linear. So this linear equation comes under simplex element. Now we are going to add intermediate nodes over here. So we will get triangular element with the intermediate nodes. So number of nodes increases to 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So if you see here, difference between these two, this is a linear equation and we are getting 3 terms extra over here. That is a4xy plus a5x square plus a6y square. So this two indicates it is a second order interpolation function, that is quadratic. So this comes under a complex element and this comes under a simplex element because it is going to use a linear equation. So next is we will move forward to multiplex element. Now this is a simple multiplex element. So all quadratic elements are considered under this multiplex element. So this is a quadratic element that is having 4 nodes over here. And if you see this interpolation function, t is equal to a1 plus a2x plus a3y plus a4xy. Only this term we are adding over here. If you see in 2D, so this is the first interpolation function, so all these three, and it is a quadratic interpolation function. So these are two extra terms, and here is one less term. So in multiplex element does not use higher order elements or number of terms in this equation. It is similar to simplex element, but less terms are there. So here are some x square terms are there in last 2D element. So here only these terms are used in this linear. So and one more property here is this axis should be parallel to this edge of this multiplex element. So it gives a limitation to use in the FEM modeling because model is always not parallel to x and y axis. So what we can do over here is we have to convert this. Suppose we are having element like this. So what we will do, we will create one imaginary axis over here in terms of zeta and in terms of eta. So zeta and eta are the natural coordinates. So now if you see, this is the axis which is parallel to these two lines. And this axis is parallel to these two lines. And we know the natural coordinate system coordinates. So if we draw these two axes over here. So this is a zeta axis. This is a eta axis. So this is converted into this. Means if you see, we getting coordinate 1, 1. This is positive side. On this negative side, we will get minus 1 here. And on this side, we will get 1 minus 1 and minus 1 minus 1. So maximum value of zeta and eta varies from 1 to minus 1 and 1 to minus 1. So now if you see here, these two lines are parallel. Now similarly, these two lines are parallel to this axis. Now it is considered as a multiplex element. So this element is parallel to x and y axis. So we will get interpolation function as a1 plus a2x plus a3y plus a4xy. Now we have used natural coordinate system to convert it into a multiplex element. So we will get interpolation function like this. Phi is equal to a1 plus a2 zeta plus a3 eta plus a4 zeta and eta. So this is the interpolation function used for this element, and it is known as a multiplex element. Now further, if we go for higher order multiplex element, so all these are multiplex element over here. This is in the quadrilateral elements family. This is in the hexahedral elements family. So linear elements are like this. It is parallel to x and y axis in Cartesian coordinate. In terms of natural coordinates, we will get the elements like this. So axis will be parallel to these two lines. In case of quadratic element, what is the shape over here on this line? It is a changing. It is not a linear or straight line. In case of simplex and complex, we are getting straight line over here. We will get in this multiplex element, shape of this edge is changing according to this quadratic shape. Now here we are getting cubic shape. Number of nodes are added intermediately, and also we will get a cubic shape interpolation function. For 3D elements, we are using this linear hexahedral element, or in case of quadratic, we will get the shape like this. One intermediate node is added in between all these, and in case of cubic, we will add two nodes intermediately and we will get the shape as per the cubic. So let's get back to this, our simplex element. So simplex element having corner edges, corner nodes, all these are having corner nodes. Complex elements having intermediate nodes over here, but they are always a straight line we are following there to connect all the nodes. And in multiplex element, we will get the advanced level, and converting it into a zeta and eta axis, we will get higher use of this multiplex element. So nowadays we mostly use a multiplex elements. So this explains about simplex, complex and multiplex element and their interpolation functions. Thank you.